Thank you for joining us. I'm Brad Smith, president of Microsoft, and I'm here today with Jennifer Yokoyama. Jen is Microsoft's vice president and deputy general counsel for our intellectual property practice. Well, a year ago, under Jen's leadership, we launched an open data campaign. It's a campaign that is focused on closing the data divide between those companies and countries that have effective access to the data that they need to innovate and those that do not. When we looked at this a year ago, one conclusion was very stark. It's that this divide risks leaving some people behind without the ability to put data to work to really generate economic wealth and opportunity more broadly. As a result, our campaign was launched with three pillars. The first was to create a principled approach for Microsoft's contributions and our commitments to trusted data collaboration. Our five principles we've since put to work have been all about ensuring that data is open and empowering, that it's private and secure, that data is usable by the people who need it. Our second pillar is about creating a broad range of new partnerships, and that's been so important, as you'll hear, to our work. We committed to launching 20 partnerships to really enhance data collaboration by the year 2022. And finally, we focused on creating new tools, developing new capabilities to make data sharing easier. 1 year on, we've made a lot of progress, but there's a lot more to be done. In fact, according to a recent Gartner survey, organizations that share data externally with their partners generate 3 times more economic opportunity and benefit than the counterparts that do not. I think that frames so squarely how we need to think about the opportunity to open up more data in the future. In fact, as Gartner found, data sharing currently is stalled. It's stalled by stakeholder resistance, by fear, by data management and governance policies and problems, and really the lack of tools and technology, and even real and perceived regulatory restraints. In other words, open data is a huge part of the future, but there are big roadblocks we're going to need to overcome. So today, 1 year on, as we reach our anniversary for our campaign, we wanted to take this opportunity to have a conversation, to talk about what we've learned, what we're working on, and most importantly, what we all can do together. So let's dive in. Jen, as always, it's great to be with you. It's even greater to be in the same room together at the moment.
Absolutely.
Well, it's a big day for us. I know we're publishing 10 lessons from our data collaboration over the past year, 10 things we've learned. What do you see as the highlights we're sharing?
So it's been great. The Open Data Campaign is really about making data as open as possible. And we've seen so many wonderful things in the last year. But what's really exciting to me is what we've learned. So the first one is, don't let open stand in the way of more open.
Now, what does that mean?
Yeah, so that means you can have open data that you want to make publicly accessible, like we did with our broadband usage data or our Bing Maps aerial data. And that's fantastic, and that is absolutely going to help value and research in all the ways that we want it to. But there are times where data won't be able to be publicly accessible because of privacy regulations or competitive reasons. Mm-hmm. And you can still get value out of that data through trusted sharing scenarios. And so you don't want open to stop you from making things more open just because they can't be completely publicly open.
That is a real insight. I know from your work, you keep finding this again and again. This is, I guess, like many things, all progress is incremental. It's true for open data as well.
Absolutely. So another lesson we learned was that open data doesn't require new data. And a really good example of that was Microsoft contributed its corporate environmental indicator data to the OS Climate Initiative, which was led by the Linux Foundation. And what that did was it took this type of environmental data from corporations, put it on an open source platform, where investors can use it to look at corporate-based climate risk and opportunities when they're looking and what they want to invest in. And so this wasn't data that Microsoft had not already opened. This was already data that Microsoft had opened to the public. But we were now able to put it on a new platform to spread the economic opportunity and the value that comes from that same data into a new platform. And so that's what I mean when I'm saying open data doesn't actually mean you need new data. There are new ways to use data.
I know that in some ways those are sort of the paths to progress, and yet we've also hit a lot of obstacles. Yeah. There's so many challenges in opening up data. And one of the things I really like about the work that you've been leading for the past year is a real focus on challenges like governance mechanisms, legal agreements, other things that slow data collaboration. And yet you've also, what I really like most of all, you've been finding solutions. Can you share a little bit about that part of the progress?
Yeah, absolutely. So tools and processes have often been the barriers that make people try to say no, like, it's too hard, I don't want to share data. And the bottom line is, we've got to make it easier. And that's one of the things we've really been focused on. And one of the projects we've been working on is in connection with the GovLab out of NYU. We did this open data policy lab where we took data stewards and people who were in the data innovation space, put them together to talk about the hurdles, tools, and thoughts about how they could overcome them to actually help make people understand how they can make data more shareable, more usable, and more valuable collectively. And through that program, they were able to talk to experts and each other, and it was such a great success that the Open Data Policy Lab is actually going to even be more open next year. So it's going to be a bigger initiative to actually take the learnings and get more out of it to try to make sharing data easier.
That's great.
Yeah. And we actually talked to Stefan Verholtz, who's the co-founder of the GovLab, about the Open Data Policy Lab, and here's what he had to say.
We at the GovLab launched the Open Data Policy Lab with the intent to support data stewards in the public and private sector to accelerate the reuse of data to benefit society at large. We need to reimagine data stewardship for a 21st century, because in essence, we need to really start professionalizing the way we reuse data. Data reuse of data is becoming essential to bridge the current divide between the data holders on the one hand and those that need access to data to inform public decisions that can improve people's lives.
Now, that is terrific. It really highlights what we're learning and, frankly, what we at Microsoft are learning by working with other people like NYU. Let me just then ask you about one last thing. Something that you and I have been working on, talking about together, is actually one of the things that I think we're really passionate about, which is how to take the power of data and turn it into an asset that really goes to work, not just for the New Yorks and Londons, but perhaps even more for the lower income countries of the world. And these are obviously places where in some instances, you know, there may not be the same level of capacity of data analytical training in place. And yet I know we see the potential as being so high. What do you think we can try to accomplish in, say, the next year or two as we really use open data to address this?
Yeah, what we've seen is that if you take data and you use it in the right way and you share it and you are able to get the insights out of it, that's where the value comes from. That's where you find the economic opportunity. So you need to be able to marry the technologies and the skills, the data skills, with these countries. And so one of the things we're doing and we're going to focus on next year and the following year is really to work in places where we can make a difference and bring these skills and this economic opportunity through data to these lower income countries by partnering with organizations like the IDB.
Thanks, Jen. And as you know, Microsoft really has a long-standing relationship with the Inter-American Development Bank, the IDB. It covers a broad range of areas. We've worked together on digital government, rural connectivity and remote education, as well as issues like responsible use of AI and digital skilling, and most recently, women's entrepreneurship. In 2020, we expanded our partnership in the area of transparency through Microsoft's new Anti-Corruption Technology and Solutions, or ACTS, initiative. This, in my view, is critical, because it helps empower the work of Latin American governments to fight corruption using technology, using data and analytics, and really importantly, leveraging open data. So we're delighted to be joined today by the IDB president, Mauricio Claver Caron. Mauricio has provided remarks, he'll be sharing them with all of us, really describing how the IDB is helping governments enhance transparency and identify corruption risks using the power of open data. Mauricio?
Thanks so much, Brad, and thanks to Microsoft for making the Inter-American Development Bank part of the Open Data Campaign. Today, I'd like to speak to you about Mapa Inversiones, a digital platform financed by the IDB's Transparency Fund with support from Microsoft. The goal of Mapa Inversiones is to expand transparency and make risks integrity known to all. Open data is a core principle of the platform. By combining open data with digital technology that aggregates and analyzes enormous complex data sets, Mapa Inversiones unleashes the potential of technology and transparency to prevent and control the misuse of public resources while increasing the participation of civil society. With Mapa Inversiones, governments, citizens, companies, and the media are empowered by data in different ways. Citizens, for example, use the platform's user-friendly interface to control and monitor in real time where and how public resources are being spent. They can interact with the platform through comments, upload photos and videos, request access to information, and file complaints in case of wrongdoing. In partnership with Microsoft Acts, we're now developing an early warning red flags pilot that will provide governments with notifications of potential fraud and corruption in the use of COVID-19 economic stimulus funds. Our goal is to accelerate analysis of the open data about government spending on Mapa Inversiones with the incorporation of relationship mapping, pattern recognition, and data visualization tools from Microsoft so that irregular transactions and practices in emergency critical procurement can be revealed. We're working on the next version of Mapa Inversiones to cast a light into the shadows where corruption risks live, and even to help prevent corruption before it even happens. We're driven in this effort by the demand of our member countries. The crisis that has hit the world, including Latin America and the Caribbean, has created the momentum for long overdue reforms. The transparency, integrity, and anti-corruption agenda is a critical area of work, and we're honored to be part of these efforts with your great support at Microsoft. Thank you so much.
Well, one of the reasons I'm so excited about what you just heard from Mauricio is that when you step back and think about it, corruption is really a problem that is as old as civilization itself. But using the power of data and combining it with technology, the leadership of the IDB, I think in the decade ahead, we have a real opportunity to take a bite out of corruption around the world. And that's really, to me, something that speaks to where our entire open data campaign is heading in the year ahead. I just want to say thank you for joining us. I hope you'll join this campaign. I think we have the power, all of us, to put data to work, to open it up, and contribute to a better world. Thank you.